He loves his own. That love leads to a third aspect of the relationship. He unites the sheep, first with himself and then with each other. Verse 16, I have other sheep which are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will hear my voice, and they will become one flock with one shepherd. Now, what did I tell you about the fold in verse 1 last week? I told you the fold in verse 1 is Israel, right? That the shepherd comes to the fold, calls out his sheep. The Lord is the shepherd. He comes to Israel, to the Jew first, then calls out his sheep by name, and they follow him. But he also has sheep which are not of the fold of Israel. I have to bring them also. Who are they? Non-Jews, anybody outside Israel, the Gentiles, the nations. This is stunning. This is unacceptable to the Jews. This is more fuel for their animosity because they resent Gentiles. They believe Gentiles are permanently outside salvation, the covenant, and the promises of God. And yet, in Isaiah 42, a messianic chapter, a messianic prophecy, we read, verse 6, I am the Lord, I have called you in righteousness. This is God speaking to the Messiah. I will also hold you by the hand and watch over you. I will appoint you as a covenant to the people, as a light to the nations, to open blind eyes and bring prisoners from the dungeon and those who dwell in darkness from the prison. There's a messianic promise that the Messiah would take salvation to the nations. Another one of those is in 49 of Isaiah, verse 6, is it too small a thing that you should be my servant, the Messiah, to raise up the tribes of Jacob, to restore the preserved ones of Israel? I will also make you a light of the nations so that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth. What about that? He's shocking them by saying, look, I have sheep not in your fold. That's why there's a great commission, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Go make disciples of all nations. And he will bring them all together as one flock with one shepherd. And that's why Paul in Galatians 3 says, in Christ there's neither Jew nor Greek, Jew or Gentile. That's why in Ephesians 2, Paul says the middle wall of partition is torn down and we're all one in Christ, Jew, Gentile. In chapter 11, verse 49, Caiaphas, making his inadvertent prophecy, he was high priest, he said to the people who were conspiring to kill Jesus, he said, you know nothing at all, nor do you take into account that it is expedient for you that one man die for the people, that the whole nation not perish. Now, he did not say this on his own initiative, but being high priest that year, he prophesied that Jesus was going to die for the nation, and not for the nation only, but in order that he might also gather together into one the children of God who are scattered abroad. That was always his intent. He unites his sheep. He brings them together to himself, to each other. So that is the relation of the good shepherd to the sheep. He gives his life because he loves them, and he brings them into intimate unity with himself and with one another. He that is joined to the Lord is one spirit, one with him and one with all others in the one body of Christ.